Would Jay and Gloria get divorced in real life?
According to our research, they might have. Welcome to our modern family reaction.
This is how not to fight in a relationship.
Okay, we're ready to go.
Wait, I had the wrong lipstick.
Oh, that's it, I've had it.
It's 1 minute.
Nothing takes a minute with you. We're leaving right now. I don't care what you have to do. It's bad enough you're being rude to me. But you're being rude to the people sitting there waiting.
That's embarrassing. There are people standing there.
I'm sorry. Yeah. You're the first to arrive, and we can't see you till everyone's here.
Happy. So I agree. She knew it all along.
Probably. What we see here is a great example of in-your-face criticism.
Thing is, though, he does have the right to voice a complaint. Mm-hmm. This is something that's clearly been bothering him for a while.
For sure, but that's exactly the difference between complaining and criticizing. Mm-hmm. Because complaining is saying that you have an issue with something, and criticizing is attacking the other person's character.
So the thing is though, right, there are good complaints and kind of the wrong way to complain. Mm-hmm. So it's not that complaining is necessarily good for your relationship either, because it depends on how you say it, mm-hmm. but criticism is just far worse because of that attack on the person's character. And him saying to her, in this case, you're rude, it's a critique of who she is.
Yeah, exactly. Time for our next scene.
You were very quiet all the way home. Are you upset at me because I honked at that old lady?
Normally we leave the honking to the driver, but I'm used to it.
Clearly it's
because of the sandwich.
Yeah. You maybe could have eaten half of it. Said a couple of nice things.
It's just a sandwich, Jay.
It's not about the delicious sandwich, Gloria. It's about being respectful of a person's feelings.
But I was just being honest.
You don't have to be honest about every little thing in a relationship. Some things you say, some things you don't.
It's a trap.
What are the things that you don't say?
Gloria, I really don't want to do this anymore.
Oh, really? But you cannot just try to teach me a lesson and then not
I don't say this, but it bothers me a little bit that you're just a tiny bit loud.
Loud?
Not all the time, only when you know, when you talk.
So I embarrass you?
Gloria.
What? Am I being too loud again?
All right, buckle up.
I'm gonna go and try to do the laundry, and I'm gonna do it very quietly so I don't bother you. Maybe Manny can help me.
I get it.
Manny!
I get it. Now you're not even making any noise.
So ridiculous. Okay, so we're clearly seeing contempt here. Contempt is when you're mean to the other person, you roll your eyes, whatever, you kind of make fun of them, you use cynicism. It's what we're seeing Gloria do here.
And thanks to Kai, I just learned the word contemptuous.
Yeah. A new word in your vocabulary.
Exactly, and being contemptuous, it's being mean and nothing more.
Right. And it's different from criticism in that it's coming from a place of superiority. Mm-hmm. It's like, I'm better than you. Criticism might be an attack on someone's character. Here, it can also be that, but with the added bonus of, I'm above you.
Exactly.
I'm above you.
And Dr. Gottman says that out of all of the four horsemen, contempt is the worst one.
Oh, wait, Dr. Gottman? The four horsemen?
Roll the tape.
Marriage expert Dr. Gottman found four negative communication styles that predict divorce. He called them the four horsemen. We just spoke about the first two. Let's get on to the next scene.
Sorry, Yay, it was an accident.
You know, I'm beginning to think you don't like Barkley that much.
Sorry, Yay.
I mean, first you hide him in the guest room and now this.
It's ridiculous. I didn't mean to hurt it.
First of all, let's cut the it's. He is a he. And you can pretend to be innocent all you want, but action speaks louder than words.
But you have to admit that the dog butler is a little ridiculous.
You know what else I think is ridiculous? That mountain of pillows you have on our bed. I feel like I'm working on a loading dock just trying to get under the covers.
They're pretty.
They're a damn nuisance.
Okay, forgive me for trying to make our home beautiful.
But you know, if I can put up with those, you can put up with a piece of art.
This is not art. This is an unholy mix between man and beast. Fine. If you love it so much, put it wherever you want.
Thank you.
This is a great example of how good this show with depicting real life.
Yeah.
Because it's a great example of the ping-pongness of defensiveness.
The back and forth.
Yeah, exactly. Because both parties are self-victimizing themselves to kind of protect themselves.
and reverse the blame mm-hmm. in this case. So for example, you see at the beginning, Gloria brings up one issue with Jay, which is about the dog butler that mm-hmm. she hates, rightly so. and then Jay turns it back around on her with a completely irrelevant issue about the cushions. Mm-hmm. So he turns it around by saying, the problem's not with me, it's with you. And they continue to do that back and forth.
And you take all three components of criticism, contempt, and defensiveness, and you get the fourth one.
Guess what happened today? Oh, I'm at the park with Joe. Now, you know what?
So, the comedic timing is so good.
She really has no patience right now.
She's away. Not even looking at it. She's like, leave me alone.
No eye contact, nothing. Not listening to him. Tuning him out completely.
I'm a little busy bee. Tell me when dinner is ready. You're
TV's
the best.
He's already on.
Why, yes, Gloria, this is a new tracksuit. Thanks for noticing.
Stonewalling is when you don't want to deal with the conflict anymore, so you shut it out any way you can. The basic premise being, if I shut up long enough, maybe it'll go away.
You take all the other three horsemen, you use them as kind of like the bricks, and with time they accumulate and become this stone wall.
Right, and the reason that this is different from stonewalling is because in this case, she's shutting out enthusiasm and appreciation. Mm-hmm. She's not shutting out conflict of any sort. She's just tired at the end of a long day, so she's tuning him out. Stonewalling is when there's a fight or something that hasn't been resolved, and you're tuning that out. But the whole aspect of the scene that is very similar to stonewalling is kind of turning on the TV to make somebody go away. Mm-hmm. Two things I want to say. The first is that if you do any of these things, it doesn't mean that your relationship is over, it just means you're human. The most important thing is not to let it become a habit. The second thing is that all of these communication styles, all four of them, are just one factor out of six that predict divorce. So even if you're making these mistakes, it doesn't automatically mean that your relationship is over.
Now, a message of hope. All four horsemen has four antidotes, according to Dr. Gottman. We're gonna have links below. To anyone who wants to read about them, who feels like they want to expand their knowledge about Dr. Gottman's research.
Yeah, we have great resources, mm-hmm. so it's really good to check them out. Please let us know if this has been helpful or if you've learned anything new today. We'd love to hear from you. Mm-hmm. Please like, subscribe, share, and comment.
Which are four antidotes.
Exactly. Those are the real antidotes.
I'm Ilan.
And I'm Chaya.
And together,
we are the Armies.